please rise to the pledge allegiance?
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic which stands one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence for the sick, handicapped, departed, and military personnel of the community.
Michael Thomas.
Here.
Bruce Allen.
Here.
Wayne Henderson.
Here.
Joe Flossmo.
Here.
Joe Lucci.
Here.
Anna Petrosella.
Here.
Regina Schneider.
Here.
Betty Copeland.
Here.
Tom McDermott.
Here.
Bruce Allen. Here. Brad King, Cheryl Rowland, Tim Black, Richard.
Is there any visitors that are speaking?
No. And I was going to ask if I could speak after you call for the
no.
Before your vote.
Because you'd like to speak.
I didn't think it is in your book.
No vote.
Well, you know what? Don't worry about that. I think we're good.
You sure?
Yeah, I.
Yeah,
exactly. Keep going.
Yeah,
exactly.
Does anybody else would like to speak?
Okay.
Now with the 2020 proposed budget.
What I did this year, which hopefully makes it a little easier to follow, was instead of doing a state of budget report, I did a line item review. It should be attached to the first one, if you're okay with it, to go through is general fund. So the review should be on top of it, and then there should be it's a general fund 2020 draft budget on the top.
Do you have it in the back of
it? Yeah, I have some hard copies in the boxes. Okay, and what I'm going to do is, what I touched on were things that may be a little out of the ordinary. If you have any questions on a line item that I haven't touched on, just please ask, and if I go too fast or whatever, just stop me. If you can just stop me and follow along on those. So as far as the revenues go, account 01-301-100, that's the real estate tax current year. It includes no increase in the millage. We have a current millage set at 6.50 mils for buildings and 10 mils for land. 301-101-103, real estate current discount, includes a 2% discount on the real estate tax current year. 01-310-320, mercantile tax collections. Prior year collections have increased in 2019, so I have increased the budget by, I believe, $6,000. Local services tax collections have slightly decreased in 2019, so I reflected a decrease of $5,000. 01-310-820, business privilege prior year tax collections have substantially increased in 2019. And the increase to date is $15,000 as what was budgeted last year. So I increased the budget from $400 to the budget last year to $7,130. Our actual is $15,780. 01-320-102 building permits. We've experienced a substantial increase in 2019 due to an increased large project. I have reflected an increase, but not what we've shown this year because that's very predictable as far as what's going to happen between now and then.
01-331-06, civil service revenues in the amount of $1,020 have been added for anticipated civil service testing in 2020. 01-381-01, miscellaneous insurance reimbursements, includes the trust reimbursement for workers' comp and liability insurance, as in previous years. 01-381-02, miscellaneous sales. I have budgeted $5,000 for an anticipated sale of public works equipment with the purchase of new equipment budgeted in line 01-437-00. And we're anticipating purchasing.
Right, where is that?
01-380-102. We're looking at purchasing some type of equipment for public work, but haven't determined what. We've received some quotes and we'll look further into it. But if we do purchase, then we would be selling equipment. So that would be minimal as far as a revenue of $5,000. 01-387-103, police overtime reimbursement. We've experienced a decline due to the lack of large projects in the area in 2019. Last year, there were a lot of large projects going on in and around the area. We bill those outside entities. We pay the police department out of our payroll fund, and the entities reimburse us for their salary plus benefits, plus we charge them for user work costs. So that's reflected in that return that we use.
Is that considered with the bridge and all that?
Yes, I don't know how much they're going to use them just because they're planning on doing the bridge replacement on weekends, and it's going to be totally closed on weekends. So, I'm not sure how much they're going to use them or not, but I'm sure they will come. So that's really the only large project that I know of coming in the area except for Collier, I think. The name of the road interchange. They may use them up there. So that's the one that we use 37103. O-1-390-101-102-M-107 are wage reimbursements from the Denture Sewer Fund and the Garbage Fund. Those reimbursements have been increased 2.5%. They aren't a large amount, but they're for wages paid out for sanitary sewer work, for sanitary sewer work in the administrative office, and for the garbage billing. So at this time, we have $5,253 to come from the sanitary sewer fund for public works wages reimbursement, $2,101 to come from sanitary sewer fund for administrative reimbursement, and $96,26 coming from the garbage fund to reimburse the general fund for wages paid for garbage billing. And that ends revenues. The 2020 proposed revenues are anticipated at $3,204,791.
Any questions?
Expenditures. We have 1,400. The administrative side, we really have no notable increases for 2020. The Finance Committee has made a recommendation of 2.5% wage increases throughout the budget for the administrative side, and that includes the Public Works Department, which will be in their second year of their collective bargaining agreement, and the Police Department, which will be in the second year of their agreement. Joe made a very valid point and had a question regarding the line item salary of administrator. 401.21, 401.22, assistant to the manager, 401.23, office secretary. I had to change those descriptions for 2020, and when I changed the descriptions, it reflected in 2019. So if you look at the 2019 budget, salary of assistant to manager was actually this Cheryl's salary this year, and the salary of office secretary actually reflected the part-time secretary in the office. What I did was I changed the line item numbers, and then if you look over at 2020, they'll actually reflect my salary, the salary of assistant manager, and the salary of the office secretary. But if you look back at 2019, you'll say, hey, wait a minute, that's a big increase because it was a different position. So. Okay, on page two. 01402, that's bonds auditing the treasurer. There are no notable increases in those lines. 01403 is tax collection. The only real change is the commission on real estate. I've increased that $1,500 to increase commissions paid in 2019. So last year I budgeted $4,500. For 2020 I budgeted $6,000. Right now she's at $59,58.47.
And that's for taxes that were not paid.
Okay, when we go into the 406s, I skip 404, excuse me. In 404, retainer, solicitor, legal fees, and solicitor, I kept those amounts the same as last year. And then we're into the 406s, which are insurances. 01406, 152, our dental insurance, we experienced a 4% increase in rates. 01406, 153, vision, we experienced a 10% increase in rates for 2020. 01406, 154, workers' compensation, which is on the next page. The fire department rates have increased 15% for 2020. We are required to insure them through the state workers' insurance fund since 9/11. And those rates have been increasing yearly. The borough workers' compensation rate.
Sorry, at 15% every year?
This is the largest this year. I think it may have been 5% last year, but it's 15% this year.
And of that amount, what is the percentage of that? Like half of it, a quarter of it?
I'd say. The borough workers' compensation rates, of which we are in the workers' compensation trust, we receive money through the trust when we our experience modifiers don't go up, and that has been working well over the past few years. Our rates have decreased 4.1% for the year 2020. 01406, 156 hospitalization, no increase in rates in 2020. But there is a calculation this year for the addition of the full-time administrative employees. We only had a partial year last year, and a move of one police employee from single status to family. So that's the difference between $700 to $1,800 a month. So that's the answer. Anyone have any questions? And if I get Medicare, it's just a percentage of it. I usually flip it to, you know, whatever increase. As far as 407, those are computer supplies, internet lines, consulting, web, those types of things. 01407, 750, computer, hardware, and software. That includes a $3,600 expenditure for a new administrative server. We have upgraded everything in our offices except for a new server. And this is going to be a cutback type of server. It's not going to be a full-fledged server because we don't really need that for the amount of PCs that we have, but we do have a couple of books, so we'll be taking a look at those. But 3,600 will cover that, and then all of our software was upgraded this year, so we're in really good shape as far as everything.
Is there any way to combine the police and administration?
No. Oh, I don't believe we're permitted to for the.
And those are all often recommendations to Secretary.
Yeah. If we commit to audit,
they.
Separate. I actually signed a purchase order for them for their server to be upgraded now. They were experiencing some failures, which were major, and they could lose a lot of information, and it was just too risky for January. So, yeah. So they're in the process of upgrading that now.
Then as far as the newsletter marketing section,
mm-hmm.
Who handles that? Is that administrative committee?
Yes. And we did talk about, and I put in my notes here, that we were going to provide some digital options in lieu of quarterly newsletters, change it up some, and to try to just make it more manageable, get more information out there. I mean, we can make copies, some hard copies, and put them throughout town or whatever.
Yeah. We there are people that, if we could do something where we find people who need that kind of hard copy.
Yeah. And just get it to them. And
yeah.
Get those hours. And give them
yeah, exactly.
Them.
Before we talked about a sign that you thought we still had in the south of the borough, a digital sign that used to be out there, is that still an option? Or
yeah, I actually have that included in the capital improvement. You're jumping way ahead these days.
Well, no, we didn't talk about that last year.
Yeah.
Our own sign out there.
Yeah.
Only that one here.
Well, I mean, it's a good conversation to have when we're talking about newsletter.
Right.
Exactly.
It can put the information on, we can throw that out on our sign saying, we're sending out digital newsletters. If you need a hard copy, please contact us.
Yeah.
Because we spend at least $850 for just on postage. And it's another $1,300 and then, of course, you have to write them. So we are required, as far as through the DEP and those type things, to get information out regarding recycling and those type things. But we can always do that on a smaller scale more often and be a lot more cost-effective. And you'd be surprised the people that call us and ask us questions. And we say, didn't you read your newsletter? And they'll say,
there's stuff like, you send out your
bill.
Print right on the bill.
We could actually do that. We could actually do a page because we have that crazy stuff around there that works sometimes and doesn't. But we actually have the capability of, doing a one page or a recorder and throwing that in with their garbage bill,
yeah.
And everybody would get that. And then
we had to do to let her get out of hand was like she would put stuff in my paper about 5 or sometimes
just yeah.
4 pages.
Right.
Yeah.
And it's nice to get that information out there. It just got bigger and bigger.
It was actually more information from other entities than it was from us.
That's the other entities we can put out on social media anyway.
Yes.
Because about anything.
Yeah.
To put that out.
Yeah.
I mean, in our world today, using the word quarterly to update people
right.
is a get.
Right.
I mean, people want stuff today,
mm-hmm.
tomorrow, mm-hmm. the next week. So we have to
go. Yeah. And I talked to Deb, and she was in total agreement. It needs to be changed. We need to do it in a cost-effective way that gets the word out there to people.
They
so,
have the problem with her with teeth turning the information out there.
Mm-hmm. Right, and right now we can just, we can put out there what we have and,
And if she's working on a deadline to get it out of the mall's organization, if you have it on social media, whenever it comes in, you throw it out there. Because you're not on anybody's schedule.
Well,
I know we use them for emergency reasons.
And we can do that. We need to get the word out. We need to really push people to sign up for our text list because it takes me 2 minutes to send it over to them, to our website people and say, put this out there. And I get a text in like 3 minutes. And, it can say, check the website, news, anything on it. Anything we want, but more people need to sign up. Yeah.
And she has included that, you know, for people to sign up in every newsletter, please sign up with a text alert, those types of things.
Maybe you can get them when they call in the office.
Yes.
That question every month, really, is just say, how about we just sign you up?
Yeah. Can
or community day, when people come up, yeah, sign up, have a text, you just sign up.
Yeah, if they give us their phone number, that's all we need, and then we can sign up, we don't need to, you know, they don't have to do it, so. Okay.
Yeah, I have a question. Do we have any idea how many, what the population age, average age is in Bridgeville?
I have it in my office. So I have a census report.
Okay, my only concern is that when you have older people that aren't computer savvy, I still think we need some sort of backup for those particular people so that we can notify them of changes or whatever.
Well, we can always include essential things in the garbage.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean? Because there aren't major changes that come to fruition, but the general things that they need to know every year can be attached to the garbage bill.
Right.
We can do a two-sided sheet that will cover everything they need to know about here.
Yes. I just don't think we should forget about the people that don't have computers or aren't on Facebook or don't even know how to sign up for text alerts.
And that's why we're talking about sending something up with the garbage bill so that they do get something.
Sure did that at Lafayette, didn't she?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so she can do that. And, you know, and we can just keep it up, and then we do throw it on Facebook, we throw it on the website.
We're
over the table,
so it's all possible.
Yeah, just for here, because it's just getting really costly for us. Okay. Alrighty, where are we here?
Engineering,
flood mitigation, 01408124. If you take a look at that line item, to date, we have expended $97,627 on hazard mitigation engineering. I have budgeted for 2020, $50,000. The reason that I've gone down in that line item is that a lot of the permitting, all of the permitting has been applied for. And grants that do come in, the engineering is built into those grants. So I'm hopeful that $50,000 will cover that because
all the labor is already in that.
Yeah. And then the grants that, as I just said, the grants that come in, there's $15,000 or whatever that you have to show was expended in that grant amount money for what you said you were going to expend.
I mean, it's like even, so we cleaned up Chargers Park, we spent, $12,000?
Actually, we got not the $2,000 saved. I thought it was the
whatever we got the bill today was not even $10,000, $9,000 and something.
So the grant we got, we can't use that for that?
You can't use the grant money that's been expended. It's only money that are to be expended.
Okay.
That's why we can't start anything until we sign the grant contract. Because if we spend any money before that, that's building maintenance. That amount, which is $16,500, includes $15,000 for carpet replacement. I think everyone will agree for carpet building. So, 01410, that's the police department.
Okay, well, a quick question. We get rid of the window cleaner? Are you going to go with windows now?
The window cleaner, we haven't had a window cleaner for 3 years. I budgeted it, but nobody ever showed up. So we had one for years. He retired and sold the business to actually a resident in Bridgeville. They showed up for one or two times, and then they've been gone. So I'll just include that in building maintenance, like once a year, or whatever, or the guys can actually wash them.
We need to keep the budget.
No. O-1-4-10 is of the police department, police chief, sergeants, and officers' salary increases for their collective bargaining agreement, as Larry said, of 2.5%. This increase is also reflected in 410-113, their longevity pay, 410-114, sick time buyback, and 410-182, holidays. I met with the chief regarding increases that he requested, which were minimal. 410-184, in-service training and meetings. We increased that in anticipated training required in 2020, including pepper spray research, firearms training, and driver's training for insurance requirements. They did have a few of the officers certified in driver's training. They have to finish that up this year. 014-206, civil service, $1,000 expenditure for civil service costs and anticipation of 2020 testing. And then all the other line items increases are minimal. The vests were purchased in 2019. We'll be receiving a reimbursement of, I think, $3,120, probably within the next month or so, from the state for the body armor. And,
there was another place in the budget at the beginning.
It was, I had it on the revenue side because they're charged. Yeah, but I didn't put the expenditure in the budget. Sorry, I left that off. So that's $1,000. And then, as I said, all the other line item increases are minimal. 01411, that's fire department. Supplies remain the same, $10,500 a year, just paid at the end of the year. What I do is their copier is on our contract, so I pay their monthly copy fee out of that line item and anything else that needs to be expended for a year, and then they're sent a check in December, normally the end of the month for the remaining. 014-11-321 fire protection, that's $75,000 budgeted for the ladder truck. 014-11-452 foreign fire insurance, that's we receive the revenue from the state on the revenue side, and we have to pass that on to the fire department by October 31st of each year. This is past October, they received $24,587. Usually carry over that number because you just don't know if it's going to be higher or lower. Most of the time it's $1,000 or two higher. And that's it for the art department. Any questions regarding that? Okay, 014-114-123. There was an increase in anticipated building permits for the experience in 2019. Building inspection underwriters are paid 80% of the revenues received, so we receive the revenues on the revenue side, of course. And this expenditure shows 80% of what we're anticipating, which I raised it this year. Last year it was $4,000. I raised it to $9,580 because of our experience this year. Today we're at $8,276.
Who are you?
Building inspection underwriters. They're out of Avalon. He's in normally twice a week, or if we have something that comes in, we call them and they'll come down and pick everything up. They do the construction reviews in that office, and then he does the visuals here.
He responds in the time and fashion.
He seems to. I haven't received complaints from them. As far as the rest of the line items went in, for that zoning building, zoning attorneys and auditors, so those types of things, there's no increase. 014-15-450 consulting fees. I continue to budget $5,000 in case we need to to use a consultant. This year, we have not, in 2019, but we did, I think our expenditures in 2018 were approximately $15,000. Okay, for 15, 450, I already went through that. Okay, we're on the 430s now, that's the Public Works Department. Now, in the Public Works Department, it's a bit confusing because you'll see the first line item says Public Works Department's salary, but their salaries are scattered throughout the budget from here to the end, as far as we charge what work they do and where. So if they're doing sanitary sewers, they're sanitary sewer department, if they're doing catch basins, there's catch basin wages. So they're scattered throughout, but what I do is I do a spreadsheet, I take a total of their wages, take all their benefits out, and then I take a look at what they utilized the past year and what needs to be done next year, and then I make an educated guess as far as what they need there. So, 430 to 250, that's at the bottom of page 7, that's tires for the Public Works Department. That has increased this year. I budgeted $2,500 last year, $6,000 this year, because we anticipate tires and rims for the backhoe, and that anticipated additional expense of $3,503. O14-3700, which is the last item in the 430, that's capital purchases. $68,315 has been budgeted for equipment to be determined for the Public Works Department.
Seems pretty specific number for
well, what
the department.
You know what? What I did was I initially got cost for a truck.
Yeah.
And then when the committee talked, we said, well, we may need a truck, we may need this, we may need that, so we need to make a determination on what we really need. So it may be somewhat more than that, maybe somewhat lower than that, but I just left the number that I had in. In fact, I actually, as far as the truck goes, I asked for a quote for an aluminum bed, which was $4,000 more than the $68,315. So if we decided to go that route, we might want to. I would say in that way, if we do decide to go with that, I thought the variation was going to be a lot more than $4,000. Yeah, it's close enough. Yeah. She sent it to me on Friday after I did the budget and got it out to you guys. She sent me the quote, and I was surprised.
So you want to put that to $73,000?
$72,000.
Yeah, I just passed my case. You guys need more need of my life.
Well, we're having so much fun.
You guys need money, we don't? Thank you.
Yeah, the meeting is set for next year.
Yeah.
You're right on time.
Just send you.
Okay, 01-432-245, that's false. We have an increase in rates with the new contract. From $70.93 per ton to $82.24 per ton, with only one bid received for the Shea Cog. We have a 750-ton requirement that I normally submit with our contract. We have an option of purchasing 120% of that 750 if we have a bad winter. If we don't have a bad winter, then we only have to purchase 80%. I have budgeted the entire 120% for $74,016, which is a $10,179 increase in the salt budget from 2019. But as you can see right now, I budgeted $63,837 in 2019, and to date, we've only utilized $42,178, and I don't need to order any more right now.
It's just that kind of eerie.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm at the 80%, and that's all we have to purchase. Normally what I do is before June 30th, I'll call them and ask them to use the 80% because they will charge us a storage fee if we don't purchase it before then. If we had room for some, it would probably be free to purchase a few hundred tons at a lower rate, but we really don't have any room for any right now. But we may before the end of the year. No, what am I saying? Our new contract starts in July. Grab that. Here's the diary. So, 01-434-251, repairs the streetlight. A quotation has been received to upgrade the streetlight control boxes, the photo cell controls, and test switches for the lighting on Washington Avenue. This quote also includes installing electrical conduit in the sidewalk for the two streetlights not working at the corner of Washington Avenue and Station Street. Total cost for all of this is $14,200. I budgeted $3,000 in addition for budgeted and unforeseen needed repairs. And these repairs that I'm talking about were not done when we did the street to state project. And I don't know if you noticed last year when the Christmas lights were on, they blew breakers all the time. Community day, the boxes in the parking lot, sparked when they tried to, try to connect them to it. It needed done for quite a while. And we have two street lights that have been out at Washington Station, and we cannot go in the sidewalk because there are fiber optics right underneath the sidewalk. So we've got to run that conduit above, and we're going to run it over to the bridge. So that includes that, so that street lights are not back on.
So who's the electrician? Who do we have to
do? We use Andy's Mickey. He gives us a fair price, and he's actually partially retired, but he comes out for us. And we've gotten other quotes, and he always beats the other quotes, plus he's an excellent electrician. Okay, 01-436-261. We're getting into storm sewer. I budgeted $45,000 to meet the continuing NS4 permit requirements for 2020. 01-437, that's equipment repairs, facilities maintenance, vehicle repairs and maintenance, radio repair. I've only increased the budget for all of those $300 this year. 01-438-262, that's miscellaneous steps and sidewalks. I budgeted $6,000 for the building sidewalk replacement in front. I don't know if you've noticed, but we have our front sidewalk is in need of repair. There are some slabs that are fine in there, but there are some slabs and curbs to work down. So we need to take care of those. Okay. 01-438-600, that's guy rail and ramp construction. That's $5,800 in the budgeted for unforeseen guy rail or ramp repairs. This year we didn't have to do any, but we had a contract with PennDOT for McLaughlin Run. When they paved McLaughlin Run, they installed 88 curbs and sidewalks, and we pay a percentage of that. Those are our responsibilities. So we don't have any contracts out for 2020 with them, but if we have an issue with something in the right of way, that we have to fix or upgrade. And I know there's a CDBG grant out there for this coming year to upgrade some ADA grants throughout the road. 01-454, that's the park. Everything is pretty much the same except for the bottom item, 01-454-387. I budgeted $5,500 in 2019. I budgeted $12,050 this year.
and that is for cameras and internet for Chargers Park. This item includes a 9-camera system installation at the park. Each cluster will be installed on existing wooden poles where power is already available. The third location will be on a pole at the entrance road at the bottom of the hill to catch license plates of incoming vehicles. There will also be an overview camera in the same location. The camera will be connected to wireless data bridges, which will push the video to a recorder housed in one of our buildings where internet access will be required. The quote includes a Verizon 4G router, which will be attached to the police department's Verizon data account for $45 a month. This cost has been included in the line item. And I'd also like to say that we had originally contacted the DA's office last year for cameras, and so that item was switched to the cameras that were installed at Auger Hill and Washington Avenue. So that the police could recognize problem vehicles in that area. So we will again apply to them and see if we can get any money for this line item. We already have a quote ready and we'll send it in to them and see if we can get any help with these at all. Maybe all of us, so we'll try. But if not, and that's something I wanted to bring to you, you know, discussions. Finance committee recommended it, but I wanted to put it in here so that it's in here, and we've been saying we need cameras down there. That's where we get the most damage every year. So, okay. 01-456-450, it says allocation, but it's actually an allocation to the library. Candy has recommended a $2,000 increase in 2020. Taking their revenue to $22,000 instead of the $20,000. We haven't raised that in many years. 01-492-123, and this will make more sense as I get into the capital improvement fund with everyone. I built this into the budget and balanced it in case that you wanted to move forward with what the committee is proposing in the capital improvement fund. So I provided 2 capital improvement fund proposed budgets for your review. The first includes already funded 2020 projects, along with some of Laughlin Run Hazard Mitigation and Bower Hill River Stormwater projects that have been partially funded with grants. 01-492-123 in the general fund reflects a loan obligation as recommended by the Finance Committee to include all projects that are in need of completion. And I'll discuss that further as we move to the capital improvement budget. So I spelled it out within the budget in the line items, and we'll take a look at that and need your recommendations moving forward. So as except for the minor changes that we made, we have a balanced budget, and I'm projecting year-end reserves of $1,250,000 for the general. Any questions?
I thought
from last year. Yes. Last year, we were probably 18-9. Due to the flood.
Is there any comments or anything from the committee and Lori put together?
Yeah, the only comment I have is for the Southfield Emergency Medical Services. They've been talking about, I think they spoke to you about support from the community. Because of their budget concerns, the changes that can't be reimbursement.
They didn't send any requests. They need to send in a formal request for. Well, we have no idea even where they're going. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Or what are they asking for? $500,
think they were basing it on the calls, the percentage of time that they spend here. I know that people have been supported, but giving them $25,000 annually based on the number of calls.
They spend,
they do have a should council wish to include the borough rate increase, the increase in revenue would total $49,798 per year. And I've adjusted the expenditure line on the expenditure side, flow reduction to reflect the increase in expense. So it would go from $79,978 to $129,777 if council wishes to increase the rate. The average monthly bill of 3,500 gallons of water would experience a $2.40 per month increase in rate with just the Alcatan increase, and would experience a $4.17 per month increase in rate with the Alcatan increase and the borough.
3,500 gallons, is that an average?
That's average, because when I gave it to you guys, I did the 10,000, and I was thinking about when we used to bill them quarterly, and 10,000 was the average for like a four household family per quarter. So 3,500 would be the monthly.
The monthly charge for Bridgeville's portion would be $1.65.
Yeah. And that, of course, we're still under the, we still must continue our point repairs, and I budgeted $400,000 for 2020 point repairs on the
this year, flow reduction, all of those things still need to be completed. We're still mandated to do them, and we've done it until it's not kind of the moment for years to come. So we have to meet those requirements.
We probably estimated that being done.
10 years?
What is that?
It's a 20-year project.
Yeah.
I remember that's about it, so knows how many years ago.
Mm-hmm.
So it did never actually roll it.
No. And I honestly, I believe that until we upgrade everything, that's just going to continue. Yeah. That's just, and I've actually included motions on the agenda for with the increase, without the increase, those types of things. So when we get through everything, then, we can go through that. But does anybody have any questions as far as those sanitary sewer budgets? Okay, garbage is very easy. We've got the recycling grant reimbursement, which gets lower and lower every year.
Is that because the amount that we're recycling is down?
Oh, they're not taking glass anymore, those types of things. So, yes. And I honestly don't know if as many people recycle as it used to. It seems to me when I look around that I see recycling bins everywhere. But when they stop taking glass, I think it kind of made a downturn because we just received less money this year.
Is that a possibility because it's not all going into the recycling?
It could be. I mean, it could be.
You're not doing a good job. No, meaning that one time they go around with the garbage and then they turn around and drive around with the same truck. And
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
You're not doing a good job separating.
Which is illegal.
Yes.
Well, yeah. That's
yes, that's the point. How do we do the moments of that? Because we see the same truck, we can't care for a grant.
I see two trucks every month.
A lot of time I do, but I don't know.
And the issue is all the trucks are the same.
Yeah.
Which, with waste management, the recycling trucks had a totally different look than
the
regular trucks.
Usually this company on recycling sends one person, on the garbage they send two.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, they're set up to recycle. One person, because it's a one bin, very small. That's where I distinguish the two factors.
I will. Now, this amount that you see reflected in 2019, that is what we recycled in 2018, of which waste management is still here. So that's reflective of what the waste management.
It'll be interesting to see what
number
it is.
Mm-hmm.
Now, and you'll be able to monitor it as well as the collection of crude.
Right. So they're required to give me a breakdown. I have to report to the county.
Right. That's why I'm asking.
Yeah.
You get the money back.
Yeah, we get money back. I have to report to the county, and then by September 30th, I have to report to the state. So we'll be able to see what they're collecting and, the difference between the glass and whatever. But, yeah, this low number actually reflects waste management. So if it's, I'll be able to tell when I get my report as far as it's a lot lower than when something's not right, something's happening. As far as the household waste program goes, we had 128 vehicles in August. We had, I think, 28 in November. The plus with that is that with the old contract, everyone was paying for that service. Whereas now, the only people that are paying for the service are the residents that are actually using the service. And they're only charged a portion, and then the borough pays a portion, and then we receive our portion back from the DEP. So we have scheduled collections for 2020 in, I think, March and August. So we'll see how that goes.
What line are you talking about?
That I was just talking about recycling and reimbursement
for DEP. You may have a little collection down here.
Very cheap.
No,
if I recall, you mentioned that we take 37,000 to eliminate the DEP. You speak about the e-waste instead of the energy. So 37,000, but we also have to compare that, it was a good service for the residents. There's no question about it.
Residents paid, in August, they paid $3,100 for the service.
Yeah.
And then we paid $3,100.
But what I'm trying to, the point I'm trying to make is we actually took service from our residents, from ourselves.
Right. Because anybody.
Yeah. Is that good or bad?
Yeah.
We do.
Yeah.
You would think it'd be cheaper. Like if we paid, you know, in 2018, we paid $37,000 to have that part of our harvest contract,
mm-hmm.
and now we're doing recycling date, you know, every, you know, quarter, whatever it is. Would they come once a quarter, everybody can bring this? We think that'd be a cheaper service. Yeah.
Only the point I'm trying to make. It's the inconvenience we give to ourselves.
Right.
We are the residents.
Right.
Is that worth it?
Right.
That we took this off from us? That could we look some other line?
Remember, we saved the price of the garbage was going up no matter what.
Oh, no question.
Yeah.
We saved $37,000.
Yes. Yeah, that's right.
So now it's only causing instead of $37,000.
Three.
If you do it twice a year.
Yeah,
$6,000. So it's six. We're actually saving money, and only people are only getting charged if they use it. How many times have you thrown a TV on the
plumber? Yeah, I went to Bedford Park. I went to a proceeding cleaner. I shopped at one day. That's what I did. The point I tried to make, we took service away from our residents, for ourselves. That's all. Nothing else. We save money, no question. We can save a lot of money if we restrict some other thing from elsewhere. But anyway, only my point here is we took service from.
Well, they saved $30,000.
Is it worth it?
Well, they were paying for it and they.
Is it worth it?
They were
paying for it if they weren't utilizing it.
And before you used to have to call me.
Yeah, well, everyone was complaining that the garbage bills were getting too high. So we would have had to raise the garbage bill probably at least $3 a quarter, maybe $4.
Am I complaining that I went to three different rates? No, I'm not complaining about that. It's just the things we do for the rest of the
time. I mean, you can do it. You can't take it from the garbage fund. You have to pay it out of the general fund.
Absolutely.
Because the garbage fund is just
unless if we increase yes, we save on the garbage collection as well.
Or you can increase the rate. That's what we did before.
Yeah.
It was included in their rate before.
Yes.
We weren't paying for it. But if you want to provide that service, you have to budget it on the general fund.
I'm with you people all the way from day one that this was done. I make my point. We get to serve as the best we can as our money.
You know how many people turned out for that last quarterly cutoff?
28.
28? So 28 people averaging about $100, so $2,800 essentially for...
No. The first one, there were 128 people that came.
One out of them, it was a line.
Yeah.
You got it, it was a line.
Absolutely.
There were 120 people that came, and they were charged a total of $3,100.
Okay.
So there were 128, and those were vehicles.
Right.
And they were charged $3,100. There were only 28 this time, so it's probably...
It was about $25.
Yeah.
So how much was the charge?
They charged by the funds. They
have
a
sheet
over there.
Thanks so much.
Yeah, great. So
now that we did this as opposed to charging.
Now, if we would take all of us, they paid $25, $2 for this item, $4 for this, and $6 for this, what would we come to? So, one way or the other, We paid the $37,000 a month.
And
we
only paid
in that rate,
so we did.
Mm-hmm.
We only paid no more than $5,000 for the year, instead of $37,000.
And we're reimbursed all on our side from the DP because they want you to have those collections. As far as the garbage rates go, when we approve the contract, it's a 5-year contract. We raised the rates the first year of the contract to $53 per household, and we stated that the rates would be held there throughout the whole 5-year contract. So there are no increases in garbage rates. Okay. Highway fund? Yeah, let's do highway fund to cap on the funds for all of those. And that's really just an in and out. As far as the revenues go, state liquid fuels money, amount expected by the state for 2020 is $147,248. The amount is received by the state's motor license fund taxes and calculated using mileage of 15.41 miles in the current population of 52.48. I anticipate because our program is late this year. They're paving late. I don't know if they started Elizabeth Street this week or not, but I anticipate at the end of the year we should have cash on hand in Elizabeth Fund 19923, so we'll be able to increase our paving program to 168411 for change.
How much of the liquid fuel goes to the public work as far as the equipment?
Nothing. We use everything.
That's correct. I know that. It's willing to make me jump into that way before when the street was done every 2 years, they used to have a public work and some other different trucks and everything. Anyway, this is perfect. I just wanted people to know that all that goes for a payment.
Okay. The last fund is capital improvement fund. Hopefully I won't complete confusion too much with this. I have 2020 draft budget and 2020 draft budget number 2. Okay, the capital fund budget includes projects that have been budgeted in previous years that will commence in 2020, including the Chartier Street widening, bridge widening, and McLaughlin Park upgrade. That must be completed in 2020 as a grant agreement expires December 31st, 2020. Cash on hand along with grant money for these projects will see the fund handling the expenses with no additional cash required. So right now, all of these projects are funded in the capital improvement budget right now. I've also included in the 2020 budget revenues grants that will be received and actual projected costs of the project with the borough share for these projects. We are expenditures over revenues $278,289. And what that includes is if you look at the 2020 draft budget, the first one.
one, you'll see that we've got the, I've listed the GEDF McLaughlin mitigation project. The revenues with the grant are $425,000. The Bower Hill stormwater project, those grant amounts are $100,000. If you take a look at the expenditure side, Bower Hill stormwater project is anticipated to cost the $100,000, nothing over, so no borough fund money required. The flood mitigation project for McLaughlin Park is anticipated to cost $710,000. So that's where you get your $278,829 revenues over expenditure. That's the balance, not budget. But balance is not budget. Fund is not budget. It's balanced. Oh my God. So that's the only thing different in this budget, because everything else has been funded in previous years. So that's what we're looking at. That's the kind of step. If you take a look at the 2020 draft budget number 2.
Can we go through this one real quick?
Sure.
So if we're looking at the revenue,
mm-hmm.
Structure Street, we're bringing in $300, or it's already there.
Yes.
So,
So
on the expenditures, where is that? Which one does that go?
Capital Project, Churchill Street. Oh, 19,492,123.
So there's the 278.
288.
288.
Mm-hmm. Okay. That's funded in this.
Right, right. And then when you have the Rockland mitigation, we're a quarter bringing in.
Yes. And take a look at 19,454,602, flood mitigation, $710,000.
They all cancel each other out.
Yes. Okay, 2020 draft budget number 2 includes everything we just talked about. And we must also consider the retaining wall projects, including Maple Street, Commercial Street, and Warner Avenue, that have not been partially funded by the GEDF grant this year, but are still on our mitigation project list. These costs are estimated at approximately $660,000. Grant applications for these projects will be submitted by December 13, 2019 for a CFA application, and again in March if they're unsuccessful. Should the grant be successful, we will still have to, a borough share will still have to be required. The draft 2 proposed budget includes loan proceeds as recommended by the Finance Committee. This is where the transfer from the general fund to be utilized for the 2020 payment and expenditures for the retaining wall project, installation of a parking lot at 416 Darby Way, where we just signed the contract to take the building down. So what the committee is proposing to do is not have the contractor do all the backfilling and seeding, and for us to move forward with making that into a parking lot. Also, we also talked about closing Darby Way from the exit, of which nobody uses because it's hard to get out, to where the entrance is with the parking lot that we rent right now. We can get 20 more feet in there and do a pretty substantial parking lot there. We may even be able to stop renting the parking lot next door. We've been spending $300 a month forever renting the parking lot that we're parking now from the Bailey. So we've included that expenditure. We've also included a digital sign to be placed. We know we don't have any room.
Wait, is this what I heard about earlier?
Yeah, we're talking about it. Yeah. We know we don't have any room on our premises except on a wall, which won't be very visible, but we also own property in a store, and we can take a look and see what the best type of sign would be and get messages out there that way. So what we're including in this is the 278-269 from 278-289 that we have to cover with the expenses for our borough share for the hazard mitigation that's already been approved. We're adding in the 660 for the retaining walls that have to be done. Warner Avenue, we're going to have to put jersey barriers up there because that road is deteriorating quickly. Commercial Street and Maple Street wall.
Warner Avenue.
Yes. We applied for a CITF grant for that one, and we called last week, and they still haven't awarded those, and that has been 9 months.
Right. I'm curious if the awards at the same time, the GDS.
Yeah, they didn't. Or they're not, they said we would, if we didn't get it, we would get a letter. If we haven't heard anything, we're still in the running. So we called last week, and that's what they told us again, we haven't heard anything. So we applied for that, and then we're going to apply again for the 660 to take that down. But in looking at it right now, saying we're not getting anything, we'd like to do those retaining wall projects. We would like to do, we need to cover the borough share of the projects for the hazard mitigation. We would like to put the parking lot in over here, and we would like to install a digital sign. Also, prospective lenders, I talked to Joe about this. We have the possibility of AIM loans, U.S. Department of Agriculture loans, PennDOT loans, or local banking loans. So we have to take a look at each of those because there are different requirements in each of those type loans for different things. So, but those are options. Some of them have very low interest rates, like 1.34%. So we will be looking at that also. But we wanted to include everything for your consideration so we could try to move forward and get things done today.
Does there no matching fund?
Pardon?
Or the matching fund?
No, AIM loans, they're loans.
Correct.
They just are specifically for municipalities or nonprofits at very low interest rates, but some geared towards sewer projects, and some geared towards, you know, this type of project or water project. So you have to see which we would qualify for. I did talk to USDA and told them what I was looking for and what I wanted to do, and we did qualify for them. Actually up to 4 years. So there's a lot to consider there, but there are options out there.
You'll give Lori a break. I mean, when we were talking to the committee, rates are so low right now.
Yes.
And we've been talking about trying to do these projects, you know, one a year. Do them all and get it done, and with the low rates, hopefully we don't extend it for a year.
No.
It helps with cash flow.
I agree.
Just hammer it and muck it.
Yeah, and I'm talking about it. Let's get the money in. We can do it.
Yeah, and we know that things need to be done and adjusted.
Yeah, it can get worse.
And I can say, I mean, I deal with municipalities all the time. I never see very many municipalities not have any debt. So for us not to have it, the achievement is all about worry of how she handles the budget and everything. And, such a low interest rate, in my opinion, it's a no-brainer to take advantage of it and get some stuff done throughout the time.
Yeah, definitely.
And let me ask you, if you do get a grant, can you still utilize that grant money towards the loan if you get it?
Yeah.
Not towards the loan, but I don't know if you agree with this, but I think what would happen would be if we got a grant, say, for $300,000, we could then, pay down.
I think
that's what we're asking. Yeah, pay down.
We have to do the whole loan, all of it.
Yeah.
If you got a grant, 6 months, 9 months later.
Because I thought before you said when you had grant money, you couldn't use it on work that had done.
No, we couldn't start it until, we couldn't start the work. Say we applied now, you know, in January to Bridgeville, which I think is smart because they're going to go up.
Yeah.
And, but say the retaining wall, we would know within the spring of the year if we got something for GDF or CFA. So, I mean, we have tons of, 2020 is going to be the year of the project. There's going to be projects everywhere. So those we we'll hold off on for a few months until we see if we get money for those. Yeah.
Yeah, we'll have the money if we need it, but mm-hmm. if we get the grant money, we can use that and not take the money, not take the loan money that we get.
Yeah. Yeah.
We'd have to take the loan money.
Right,
and
but I mean,
not the grant.
But that could be, yeah.
Yeah.
So then our cash flow payment, let's say it's been 4 years now, because we made that huge principal payment, now it's 30 years.
We just have to be really prudent not to start a project, you know, before grant money is coming in. But if we see that it's not happening, especially if they weren't out and have to be done, then we need to move forward.
I think we need to say there's a wish list.
There's a
much more transparent part. Well, I mean, it's a valuable conversation.
Mm-hmm.
There are a lot of projects we've talked about.
Yeah.
That's one. Just coming up.
Yeah. We actually are applying for an updated permit from the DEP for Chargers Park Road because we had one, but it has been expired. So we're applying for an update on that, and we need to get an estimated cost on that. And we were hoping to do, we get started on the Chargers Park comprehensive plan, which would have included that road. But when the flood hit, those things got way too easy to cut us off. The immediate expense that had to be incurred. But yes, the Chargers Park roadway is something that needs to be
incurred. Oh, mind you, I mean, we're figuring this payment out. 12 months of those payments is an annual that goes toward your budget. So your payment has to be acceptable from part of your budget. So we have to take that. You can't be, let's raise it to 1.5 now. Like,
yeah.
Well, in our budget, that doesn't allow that payment, that kind of payment.
And the 89,000 that I show, the transfer to the capital improvement fund, is the max that I can get out of the budget.
We kind of work backwards.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, that was the max I could get out. So that was the 1.1 million was the max that we could apply for because I can't get any, we can't make a higher payment than that.
The only concern I had is, are they going to be picky with the USDA?
I think they'll be pickier than with the local lenders. The USDA, I said, here, I'd like 1.1 and here's what I'd like to do. And they said, well, you don't qualify for distress rate, but you qualify for this rate, and yes, you can do this. And then we talked about closing costs and those types of things, and I did shoot an email regarding that. And I think he answered me, but I didn't have one of my fingers. But that's all I know.
As far as what I don't see a problem.
I have a question.
Just it wouldn't matter what kind of rate. Would they get it as tax equivalent? Would they get it as regular?
Mm-hmm.
How much are closing costs and things? Mm-hmm. I think you'll probably get a tax equivalent probably around $250,000, $270,000 and $3,000 closing costs or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of just regular rate, probably in the high threes, closing costs.
I think the USDA can be higher than that.
I do. But the local bank wants to go for you.
Right.
So that's the trade off the table.
Right. And we'll provide all that information. You know, we'll talk to all of those entities when we go further into it. You know, people or whatever.
make a definite decision, but we wanted to include it just so that we're moving forward.
My question, I noticed in the salary that the 2.5% they went across the board.
Yep.
Should have been.
Yep.
That was okay. Should we have an executive session on something else here? Do this question. Vote. You want to vote? That's our question.
You feel that we need. You have any other?
It's fair to go on the private. I have no problem with the expense.
You want to adjourn?
Oh, wait a minute. We have to make our motion.
Yes.
We're going to get an executive session.
But, yeah.
No, that's it.
Because then we need to come back and make a decision.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that's.
You
have the only reason why we wouldn't adjourn.
You have another month to recover. Feel free to come to.
Hey, you want to give that proposed word?
Number one, zero, one, one?
Yes.
Okay.
Proposed word number 1011, motion to approve conference regarding authorization for assisting the government to prepare proposed word number 1011 and manager calling to advertise the same ordinance amending the current rate charge for sewer service within the borough of Bridgeville with the Allegheny County Sanitary Sewer Authority. Increase of an additional 58 cents per 1,000 gallons of water usage and $1.17 per quarterly bill increase of the service charge. Borough rates motion to determine. 2019 rates, off stand rate was $7.92 per 1,000 gallons. Borough rate no increase was $6.23 per 1,000 gallons for a total of $14.15 per 1,000 gallons with an officing service charge of $16.69 per quarter. 2019 rates, an officing rate of $7.92 per 1,000 gallons.
So, now it is confusing because what I did here is the top numbers for 2020 include the Alcatan increase and no borough increase.
Okay.
The bottom numbers include an Alcatan rate increase and a borough rate increase. So it's whatever council decides which one that they want to incorporate.
And then the bottom includes the 50 cents per million gallon increase.
Yes.
Right, so. And then the 2020 rate would be, top of sale would be $8.50 per 1,000. Borough rate would be $6.23 per 1,000 for a total of $14.73 per 1,000. The Elfsand surcharge of $17.86 per quarter. And then the Elfsand rate of $8.50 per 1,000. The borough rate $6.73, which includes that 50 cent. For 1,000 gallons for a total of $15.23 per 1,000. We talked about keeping up with all the things, correct?
Yeah.
But we're about the second one done. I'll make a motion for the 850. And the $6.73 a total of $15.23.
Can we make that in the same motion?
I just gave it to you to pick it. I didn't know which one you wanted to do.
You gonna make the motion? Public hearing advertisement, motion for a contact, authorizing the mayor to advertise a public hearing on Monday, December 9th, 2019, 6:30 to review the proposed ordinance number 1011, ordinance regarding the 2020 off-stand and borough sewer rate.
So moved.
Bruce?
Check.
And Neil, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries.
proposed ordinance number 1012, motion of the Borough Council authorizing the manager calling to advertise proposed ordinance number 1012, ordinance fixing the tax rate and levying borough taxes for the fiscal year 2020 and reenacting all other revenue tax.
So move. Bruce?
Second.
Bruce, motion to adjourn.
Do we need to have more direction for you on which way to go?
As far as the capital improvement, yes, I need for council to tell me which ones you want to be available for public review.
You got to look at the capital.
For the capital improvement. All the projects, including the ones.
I would like to see the project team.
It's just part of the budget process. It's just direction on how you're spending money.
Did you have any agreement with that? Joe, what do you think?
If not, we're going to have to make a determination. If we go with the one without the additional projects, then we're going to have to go $284,000 in some way.
Yes.
It seems like you're also actually thinking about something. I appreciate you allowing me to say that you are.
I mean, actually, it's getting done. That's what you're
saying. That's okay. You need me to stand up. Joe commented, this borough has been in excellent financial health. It has not had debt for many years. It came into office, but it was not debt. Now, yes, there is a laundry list of things that need to be done. Some of which are paying for our neighbor's traffic, which I have commented on in the last meeting. I don't believe that it is prudent to have debt to pay for for an electronic sign, especially after the controversies we went through to tell people in this town that they shouldn't even put one up. Okay? It's amazing how we change our position. There are constraints. We should live within our means. We should not put a burden upon the next generation, okay, of having to pay for a wish list of projects. Yes, Warner Street needs to be done. Yes, there are some good matching grants that need to come in. Do the job and choose. Okay? Choose some of them. You don't need all of them. A parking lot next door would be very nice. A sign. I don't really think it's all that important. You don't need all of these pieces.
Just one comment on the sign.
Sure. I mean, it's probably
what the guy's paying me. I'm sorry.
My comments about the sign are trivial.
Right.
But I'm more than welcome to hear your response.
As far as the expense we had in the newsletter,
mm-hmm.
We could look at using some of that expense, the sign, would you amortize that over 5-7 years?
I think you could save the newsletter and the sign. I don't think
well,
either
of you.
I think that Lori has an excellent idea, and as Cheryl Ward has done in North Hill, or North Bay, sorry, of putting it on the other side of the garbage bill, which Joe even concurred with. Again, the sign is trivial. We're speaking on.
You keep bringing up the sign, that's why I wanted to say.
Because it's permeated through your discussion, okay? Of the little thing. And then during a large project, like a parking lot next door for the borough building, like an improvement project at Churchill Street, which I strongly support, but do not think we should be paying $488,000 for. And now you tell me that you're going to lay debt on this borough to do it. If you don't have to pay $488,000 for our neighbor's traffic, you don't have to borrow money.
And the contract is in signing and sale for the with Vendor with that project. And then it's really hard to take this thing back
mm-hmm.
or half of that or whatever. I know what you're saying, and we discussed it so many times. Am I in favor to take that $450,000? Yes and no. It is a balance here that we have to. Yeah, we want to keep. all this bad. I'm good with look with bad dog. They're going to do that.
We're not going to look any good or bad or up or down.
They're going to do this project whether or not we put our money into it or not.
You're absolutely right. If we pull down money, they probably would still do that project.
Yeah, no.
What about the next project we want to do in the town?
It's not going to matter to that project either. No, it won't, Lori. It will not matter, Pat.
If me and you were in business and you screwed me,
mm-hmm.
and you said you're going to do something and you said you're not going to do it,
mm-hmm.
the next time I was going to do a project.
You're not. I understand. We're not. We're two individuals.
These are
governmental entities. They don't work that way. I do not believe that they're individuals. But let's assume you're right. And they won't come through with the quote next project. So be it. And I am one of the greatest advocates for that project and the North End project and a number of projects that depend entirely on PennDOT funding. I stand before you putting something that I care about on the table because I care more about not getting this borough into debt. If you say to me, like, that project is vital, I agree with you, it is. You want that project to go through, then perhaps you look at some of the other things that you put in your wish list, and well, you know what? Maybe we really don't need some of the other things. Now, I'm not a particular advocate of looking at the walls on Maple and the wall at Warner. You could close down Warner. I don't like that idea. I think that's a horrible idea. But some of these other projects could be cut out. Do the job.
We didn't do the wall in Maple.
No,
mm-hmm.
We actually really chose not to.
I understand. That's why I didn't put it on my list. I have my idea of.
You have to think about those people on the line.
Of course, and I think that both of those projects are far more important than Chartier Street and PennDOT.
You're right.
Okay.
You're right.
Chartier Street and PennDOT and our neighbors' traffic, we don't have to pay for. And that's why I put that project on the table.
I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
We don't pay for it now. We're going to pay for it later.
Which one? Chartier Street?
All of it.
Chartier Street?
All of it, Pat. There's a better chance of getting interest rate now that we can afford. I don't know a single person who doesn't live in debt. Everyone has experienced debt in their life.
Yes.
Right. Yes or no? Yes. You agree?
Yes, right?
And this is something we can work with.
Is
that something that we can start now?
Uh-huh.
We get people more involved if we do these things for our community now.
What are we getting them to
we do these small things for them that they've been asking for years?
The people in Warner have been asking
exactly.
for the last 8 months since their hillside fell down. This isn't something we're doing.
All these projects.
These weren't on our wish list. What they tried to put on the wish list
is. Opportunities there.
Yes, but they pulled those off. The wish list isn't going forward. These are projects that, as council saying, we have to do. Warner, Maple, these are projects that we have to do.
I never forget that the day we reject, that's what a year after I come in, that we rejected the winding on Richardson Avenue on the south end. We added so many people that we used the school
mm-hmm.
down the gym to have a meeting with school like that.
Oh, I remember it. I vividly remember it.
Never forget up front standing right there.
Uh-huh.
When we reject that, not run, that not run was an engineer
uh-huh.
of PennDOT to this day. I read his lips, what he said.
Uh-huh.
And I don't want to say nothing.
Uh-huh.
Okay? And it took so many years for us to do that, but it did it. But it didn't do it the way it's supposed to be done, but it's close to it. Okay?
No.
Yeah. You didn't
not
find the way to quit. My point is bad. We lost so many years that it took time for us to regain that.
No, we don't. No. What changed?
If I would put that motion, I bet you I don't even get a second.
Which
would have been $1,000 to take their money back. Not to pay. I bet you I don't get a second.
I think you get a second.
No, I don't think so.
Right, I think you might get a second.
I wouldn't get a try, but I don't want to embarrass you. I don't make that way.
I understand what you're saying.
I'm
not embarrassed. I think you'd get a second on that,
no.
Nina. But I point out to you that what happened decades ago when you told PennDOT no to the road widening on the south end, and you remember that because you were on council.
But
the
it was not a motion
not to put money. It was a denial of allowing them to do the project. You didn't pull money. You told them no, and you continued to tell them no to widening the south end of Washington Avenue for a decade until finally they told you they were going to do it even though you didn't want it.
20 years after.
20 years and they
answered. Well, there were two individuals, a church and a restaurant.
I remember the wonderful controversy about it, but the point is, it was not about money. They never asked for the borough to pay. They weren't asking for borough money.
Yeah, but
we just agree to disagree.
Yeah, let's go.
If I may.
Yes,
I just want to tell you a true story about PennDOT. Why I was very, very careful on doing any business charges of any amount of money with anything. Two bridges near downtown Philadelphia condemned. PennDOT could not get to it until 2024 because they had all these roads to fix. So whoever it was hired a company out of Chambersburg, whatever. And they did both bridges, same amount of money in 365 days.
Mary, you have to agree that that project will help, will benefit Bridgeville.
Oh, absolutely. But why should we wait 10 until 24 to get something done with bridges? We may need bridges more than we need.
We need 2024. That bridge will be done next year. That bridge is being done next year.
Yeah. And not only that, Pat, there's $300,000 in grant.
Yeah.
Part of that $500,000.
Well,
so I don't know. I mean, at least we got money to do it.
Mary, that's not a project. We started that 6 years ago. No, not even 3 years. And it's getting done next year. It'll be done.
Yeah.
That's unheard.
You see them out there. Preliminary work is
being done. They're saying,
"Let's go to the